now introduce to you our very own Maulana Imran Hosein.
Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. We begin with Allah's blessed name. We praise Him and we glorify Him, as He ought to be praised and glorified. And we pray for peace and for blessings on all His noble messengers, on our father Adam, on our father Abraham, and on Moses, and on Jesus, and on His mother, the Blessed Virgin Mary, and on the last of them all, the Blessed Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam. Many years ago, we had a leader in this country who got up in Woodford Square and spoke for hours and delivered a historic address. It had matterly done what he meant was that we must ensure that Masa's day comes to an end. When Dr. Williams, the founder of the People's National Movement, delivered that address, I was proud to be a Trinidadian, because he recognized oppression. He recognized a slave master. He denounced oppression and he challenged the slave master. That was someone with a backbone made of steel. There has been oppression in the Holy Land. Slaughter of innocent women and children, destruction of the houses of God. For 3 weeks now, unprecedented oppression by a beast of the earth. You're familiar with that expression, aren't you? And I ask, where are the leaders of this country? There is a local expression, I think, that they cap cut the tongue. That's it. Where's Savannah? Historic language. To continue to put a question mark behind your name. How long will we wait for someone from the People's National Movement to follow in the footsteps of Dr. Williams and to declare Masari done? It's almost 50 years. And so we invite them, the Muslim community of Trinidad and Tobago, we invite them politely to speak out so that integrity might be established. How many more must be killed? In the brief moment that we have with you, we wish to attempt to explain, to offer an explanation of this continuing oppression and to seek to identify the beast who is oppressing. Our holy book, the Quran, has spoken on this subject, and it allows us to recognize that what began with the Crusades 1,000 years ago, the Crusades which we were told were Christian wars to liberate Jerusalem, but which we now recognize were European wars masquerading as Christian. And incidentally, Jesus Christ was not a European, was he? No. That those crusades are linked with the birth of the State of Israel. For 1,000 years, Europe waged war to liberate the Holy Land. And then to bring the Jews back to the Holy Land to reclaim it as their own. 2,000 years after the God of Abraham had destroyed Israel and expelled them and scattered them all over the world, Europe brought them back. And then in 1948, a State of Israel was born. 2,000 years after Israel was destroyed, can all of these things be happening by accident? We ask. The University of the West Indies. We ask. The Trinidad Guardian and the Express and the Newsday. We ask the television stations of this country, which remain so silent on this issue. No, it is not happening by accident. When they said that what we are doing is to try to give to the Jews a Jewish homeland, a place where they can live in the Holy Land, that was not true. That was false. Israel's destiny is far more than to offer a home in the Holy Land. Israel's destiny is now becoming clearer and clearer. They are the ones who put Barack Obama where he is today. Without him, Barack Obama could not be where he is today. And they are the ones who will declare, stand up and you must stand, sit down and you must sit. And so who rules the world today? Is the world being ruled from Washington? Or is the world being ruled from Jerusalem? That's the question I ask of you. To tickle your intellect. To force you to think that it's not just a land for a people to live in, but rather a sinister agenda to create a new ruling state in the world. That Israel will rule the world. We're very close to that now. And it is this book, Jerusalem in the Quran, which explained that subject from the Quran. This smaller book explaining Israel's mysterious imperial agenda is something that the Trinidad Guardian would be familiar with, because the entire thing was published in the Guardian a few years ago. The sinister agenda of creating a ruling state from Jerusalem is now approaching its climax. Why do they want that the world should be ruled from Jerusalem, and that they are going to pursue this objective even if they have to slaughter and kill, and even if they have to create another, listen to the word, because it's there in the Bible, another Exodus. They had one in 48, and as a consequence of that Exodus, we now have Palestinian refugee camps in Lebanon and Palestinian refugee camps in Gaza. And those who are being killed in Gaza now are refugees. Is it that another Exodus is on the way? Why do they pursue this objective in such a barbaric way? Is it because you are now dealing with the beast of the earth? And why does Israel want to rule? I'll tell you why, and then we'll end. Because tomorrow, when Israel rules the world, when Israel wages the big war, when Pakistan's nuclear plans are destroyed, when the state of Israel expands its territory to encompass the biblical frontiers, which of course is false, from the river of Egypt to the river Euphrates, when Israel takes control of the Suez Canal, when Israel takes control of the oil of the world, when the US dollar collapses and eventually is demonetized, so if you have any US dollars underneath your pillow, you can use them as wallpaper. Tomorrow, when the price of oil, which is now around 35, reaches up to 350, when the price of gold reaches up to $2,000-$3,000 an ounce of gold, when the U.S. economy collapses, and the blame, of course, for the collapse of the U.S. economy is put on the black face that the white man has put, tomorrow Israel will rule the world using weapons of war never used before. And when that massa, with his ugly foot being stamped upon the weak and helpless, rules the world, then a man will emerge. 1400 years of our Prophet Muhammad, Allah's blessing be upon him, described that man. He said he'd be a young man. He said he'd be powerfully built. He said he'd have curly hair. He said he'll be a Jew. And that man will stand up in Jerusalem and declare, I am the Messiah. But he would not be the Messiah. He would be the false Messiah. He would be the Antichrist. He would be Dajjal. But they don't teach this subject in the schools of international relations. And so we are moving towards a climax, a culmination that we already know of. And we have to suffer. But all those who are being killed in Gaza, innocent people, are entering into heaven. And I'm proud that my people are entering into heaven. And those who are killing them, and those who are supporting them, and those who are their clients, and those who ban the scholars of Islam in this country and declare that they are terrorists and declare that they are great security risks, all of them, all of these house slaves will enter into the hellfire. We won't pray over your body. We won't stand at your grave. For you are traitors. We don't want you in our midst. Because tomorrow, Prophet Muhammad said, there's an army that is coming. And that army will come from Khorasan. And the heart of Khorasan is Afghanistan. And he said, when you see the black flags coming from the direction of Khorasan, he said, go and join that army. Don't allow the Constitution of the Republic of Trinidad and Tobago to stand in the way. Go and join that army. Don't allow the Security Council of the United Nations to stand in the way. He said, go and join that army. Listen to his words. If you have faith in your heart, and if you worship Allah, and you do not worship at the altar of a U.S. visa. He says, go and join the army, even if you have to crawl over ice. Those are his words. The army is going to liberate every single occupied territory in a straight line from Khorasan until it reaches Jerusalem. And I pray that there will be in that army our sons from this country, inshallah. And so, there is mist in your eyes today, as there is mist on the mountain tops. There is mist in your heart today. Today we weep for men, women, and children, al-mustada'afuna fil ardh, crying out to the heavens, Rabbana akhrijna min hadhihi al-qaryati zalimi ahluha. O Allah, kindly liberate us from this town of oppression, Jerusalem. But Allah is testing. He's testing to see who are those who have faith. Whether you be Christian, you be Hindu, you be Jew, you be Buddhist. If you have faith, if you have truth, then that truth must lead you to stand up against oppression. And if it is not, if you join the United States as India is doing today, then we ask, where is the truth that you have? Tomorrow, the day will come when the sun will shine again and the truth will triumph and justice will prevail in the world. And on that day, Masa de Dan. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka anta as-samir alim wa tub alayna ya mulana innaka anta at-tawwab rahim bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin. Amin.